Okay, now is it visible the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so once again I have prepared this by using a CamDraw software where we are writing the structures. So what type of questions are there in our question paper that we are going to see first in the set question paper, and then we'll solve all the types of problems which have been asked in the set exam, as well as we will go like from the graduation level, post graduation level, then after that set and NET and GATE exam type of questions level. So first here there are two questions in each question paper, like for 2 marks one question, that means total 4 marks are there for finding the total number of protons or different types of protons. Okay, so as I have written here, number of different types of protons are equivalent to the number of NMR signals. That means if you found 2 signals in the NMR, that means there are 2 different types of proton, or vice versa. That if there are 2 different types of proton, you will find the 2 NMR signals. For example, see here, in this is the problem from your SET exam, the number of chemically non-equivalent proton in H1 NMR spectrum of 2-pinene. Okay, so either they will give the name or the structure, or they will give both. Okay, and the options are like 7, 10, 9 and 6. We have to find it today only. Again, there is a second question. Number of signal observed in this particular structure in H1 NMR proton decoupled and C13. So H1 and C13. So today we are going to talk about this H1 NMR. And here, if you see, this is a complicated structure, but today we will find how to answer this. Then there is another question that they have not given the structure, but they have written only the name. So such type of problems are there. Along with this, see, a different type of problem is there. So you have to just match the following one signal in H1 NMR. So there are structures are given. So you have to just match the following, and the answers or the objectives are given over here. So you have to choose the correct option out of these 4. So we are not going to find the answer directly of this complicated structure, but we will just go like one by one. So here, this structure which is seen over here, this structure, what it will give us, it will give us an idea about the, just a minute, we'll just open this file again. Okay, so if you just listen it carefully, that we have total 4 marks for this particular section. Now what I will do, I will zoom this particular structure so that it will be clear. Okay, yeah. And okay, so there is a first problem is there. Okay, here what we have to find, that you all know that this in any chemical structure or the anion structure, there is CH, CH2 and CH3. These 3 types of carbons bearing hydrogens are present: CH, CH2 and CH3. Now here there is this particular structure is there, its name is ethane, and it is CH3 and CH3 is seen. So what question they are asking? Tell us the number of different types of proton over here. So here CH3 and CH3 both are the same. If you see here, there is a symmetry, right? So both are equivalent. So how I can distinguish between them? So for that purpose, I have written the same structure and I have just labeled it with the help of 2 different colors. Though these 2 colors are different, we cannot say that these are the 2 different. But they are like a same. Why they are same? Because they are attached to one another and they are having a same environment. See, CH3 is having adjacent CS3 and CS3 is having CS3. So I have to label. So what I will do, I will give as an A. Just a minute. Yeah. So here I will label it as an A, and here I will label it as a B. So A means only one type of proton. So what will be the my answer? This particular structure will have one different or only one type of proton. So if one proton is there, number of signal will also one. So there are total one signal. So as we go further, we will understand what this particular topic represents. See, now this is this next structure. Its name is ethyl bromide. So here there is a CH3 and CH2 is there. Okay, so CH3 we already have seen that CH3 is different than CH2. Here I have labeled this with the CH3 with the blue color, and this is a black color. So see, CH3 is having CH2 to its adjacent, and this CH2 is having Br as well as CH3. So both are the different, and what we are finding, number of different types of protons. So protons are nothing but hydrogen, right? So this is like we call it as an A, and this will be B. So A and B is total, these are like a two types of protons. So what will be my answer? Two types of proton, and I will get two different signal in the NMR. Okay, so this is the case for this particular structure. Now I have this particular structure. Now can anybody tell me what will be the, how many numbers are there? If you know, just say yes, otherwise
we sorry may I
1, 2, 3, how many types,
ma'am? Sir, there are two types of proton.
Yes, two types of proton. Which two? CS3 and this CS3. Yeah, these two are equivalent. Equivalent means both are having CH2 to their adjacent. Or even if you see, there is a symmetry in this structure. If you put here an axis, you will find that CH3 and CS3 are there. So this is a symmetrical structure. And if I label them with the help of different color, I can easily see that these two are same and this is the different. So what I will do, I will give you an A. This is A and this one will be like a B. So total number of protons will be 2 and total number of signals will be again 2 for this particular structure. So if I keep changing the structures, I will find different types of proton. Again, this structure. What will be your answer now? This CH3, this CH3 and this CH3. Mm-hmm. All the three CH3s are attached to the CH. So again, I will give the different coloration and I will find that these all three are same. So that's why those are like, this is A type, this is A type, this is also A type, and the middle ones, CH is there. So it will be like a B type proton. Okay. So again, my answer is two types of protons and two types of signal I can find. So as these are like open chain compounds or open chain ring system. If I have benzene now, see, if I have benzene, if I put it into the NMR machine, what I will get? So can anybody tell me, for benzene there are 6 hydrogen, right? So what will be your answer now?
One.
How many different types of protons?
One, sir. One.
See, there are all the 6, or all these 6 hydrogens are look like this. All are same, right? So if you select anyone, they will have hydrogen, 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 hydrogen on one side, and on similar means both the sides they are having only hydrogen. So that's why we can say only one type of proton. So what I can say, one type proton which will give one type of signal only. So this type of questions are in the like a graduation level. These are very, very simple. So what we will do, we will increase the little bit its strength of the question, what, how they are asking. Now in our question paper of MSc as well as this in the SET exam, such a type of problems they are asking. Again, I will little bit zoom in because it will make a complication in understanding. See, here this type of structure is having a benzene, and here there is a methyl group, here there is a methyl group. So both the groups are methyl group and the R can be shown here. Yeah, so this is the structure. Okay, and this is known as a para xylene. If I again give the coloration, see this CH3 and this CH3 same. Why it is same again? Because it is having a plane of symmetry like this as well as this. If I put a axis over here, then I can find the half of the structure is on one side, which is exactly equivalent to the other side. So this is having a symmetry. So that's why these two are same, CH3 and CH3. What I will do? I will label them as an A. Now what will be the next step? There are again hydrogens are present. Only these hydrogens are there. So all are again same. So that's why I will label them as an B, B, B. So this structure is important. This structure is already been asked in the question paper. So if A and only B are there, I will answer that there are two different types of protons. So those are responsible for two different peaks in the H1 NMR. So this is the next structure, aldehyde. Okay, so this is an aldehyde, acetaldehyde we call it. This is also very clear. See, only one CH3 NH is there. So I can again give it different color. CH3 is will having one color, so it will be A. This will be like a hydrogen, it will have a B. So I can again give label this as number of protons, two different types of proton will give two different peaks. Again, we will go for slightly complicated structure or different structure than this structure. See, this problem is there in our exam. Okay, so this type of a structure, if it is seen that this like we called it as a Norbornel type of system or fused ring system, so this will look like this. See here, if you count these hydrogens or this carbon, how many carbons are there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I will write a hexagon here, and here this one number and four number. Why 1 and 4? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 is joined by with the help of these two CH2s. So this is CH2. Already I have explained this, that carbon will make 4 bonds. So here already 2 bonds are made by it. So there will be 2 hydrogen. So this is a CH2, CH2, all are CH2. So I can draw this type of structure. Now what should I do? How I can represent, how I can give the coloration to this? Okay, I'll slightly zoom out again, see this structure. Okay, here all are CH2. How many CH2s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So all are equivalent. All will like A type, this is A type, this is also all are A type, A type, A type. But there are 2 carbons remain here and here, which are having 3 bonds. So that means last atom will be here as an B. So this will be B, and I will get 2 different types of proton, which will give 2 different signals. So again, this is a little bit of simple or straightforward type of a structure is there. In the next structures, you can easily see this is like a slightly different. Number of protons are more here. How? See, this is a toluene. Benzene is having a CH3 over here. Okay, so again there is a one CH3 and all are remaining hydrogens, but they all are not same. Why? See, I have give the color by using a different colors to this particular structure here. See, CH3 is shown by black color, and these two hydrogens are now with blue color. These two are with red color and this is a green color. Why this? So because if you see, these two hydrogens are having, both are having CH3 one side and hydrogens on the other side, but these two are don't have the CH3 to their adjacent, right? So that's why these two are different. This is totally different than these two. So there is again symmetry is present on this axis. Okay, so now I can label with the help of colors, or I can simply just write down A on the B. This will be B, this will be C, this will be C and this will be D. So I reached up to the D, that means four types of proton which will give four types of signal in the H1 NMR. Again, there are few structures which are slightly simple as we have seen here, but they are showing a different signal than which is explained over here. See, now CH3, C double bond O, this is CH2 and this is CH3. Now you can say that means, sir, there is a CH3 here, there is CH3. So both will be like equivalent, right? Both will be equal or same, but this is not the correct. Why? Because see, this CH3 is attached to the carbonyl, but this CH3 is attached to the CH2. That's why this CH3 will give one peak, CH2 will give other peak, and the last C or the third carbon or CH3 will give the another peak. Okay, so understand, this is very simple. So that's why, what should I write here? That I will get three different types of protons, so I will get three different peaks over here. Okay, now little bit, yeah, complicated type of structure. Again, this CH3, C double bond O, CH2O, CH2, CH3. Again, this CH3 is different than this CH3. Okay, so both are different. So that's why what we can say, that these two are different. But now you also say me that, sir, this CH2 and this CH2 will be the same. But it is not the correct. Why? Because this CH2 is attached to the carbonyl and this CH2 is attached to the CH3 over here. Though they are attached to the oxygen on one side, but on the another side, they have the different partner to attach. So that's why I can give the labeling as A, B, C, D to them like this. A, this will be B, this will be C, and last CH3 will be D. So again, I reached up to the D. So I will say that there are four different types of proton, which will give me four different peaks in H1 NMR. Okay. Now again, similar type of structures that we have seen up till now, all are like very, very simple structures, and they are been like asked in the only graduation level. Okay. So now, I think this file we have seen already. This is a fourth. Yeah, we will go to the next. This is the next. Okay, see this CH3 here. I'll zoom it so that it will be little bit clear. Yeah, see this CH3 and this CH3. Now I can say that both are the same AA type. Why? So if I put again here an axis, I will get both the groups same on both the sides, right? So there is a structural symmetry, and on each page on the top, I have written that mutually equivalent protons do not couple. So they will not give any type of signal in the, or they give the, both are giving a simple or single type of a signal here, mutually equivalent. So these two are equivalent, CH3 and CH3, both are the equivalent. Equivalent means they are having the symmetry, and that's why they are having the same. So this CH3 A type, and CH2 it will be like a B type. Okay, so this is the one case that there are, we are finding a two. Now again, there are two complicated structures like this. Can anyone tell me what is the name of this structure?
Anthracene, sir.
This is an anthracene. Okay, so now they will ask such a type of question, and what they will ask, how many different types of protons are present. So same, what you have to do, you have to give the labels to the only the protons which are different. See this structure here, there is a hydrogen, but here there is a no single hydrogen because its valence is complete. Now 1, 2, 3, and 4, so here there will be no proton. Only at these edges there will be one protons are there. Again, there is a symmetry. If I put axis over here, these two will be the same. So AA, then this position is same for this as well as this. So this will be like a B, B, and B. So AA, then this B, and last one is the C. So again I reach up to the C, that means I can say there are three different types of proton which will give me three different signals in H1 NMR. So if you are not satisfied, or if you want to prove this by using certain parameters, so here in this software, as I have told you, this will give us total idea about this. See, if I select this structure and if I go into this structure here, and if I just simply click on the H1 NMR, we are seeing H1 NMR here, right? So there are only three types of peaks can be seen. Okay, so these two peaks are so close to each other, they will be like, I will try to zoom in here. Okay, so they will give us three different types of peak over here only. Okay, and I will show you again in the next structure, because this is, these two peaks are like almost same, they are having a very similar type of peaks, or their chemical shift values are so close to each other. Now we will go for the next sixth number. See here, just now I think we have seen this particular, what I will do, I will try to get the structure for this. You can see only two types of peaks are there, 2.09 chemical shift value, 2.09, so this is one, and 3.61, so this is the second. So only two types of proton. What we did, we calculated here A and B, so two different type of proton, and this will prove us, or our statement, that number of different types of proton will give number of different peaks. So many times they will ask the question which one of the statement is correct. So that's why this particular thing should be remembered, that number of different types of proton will give us number of different peaks in the H1 NMR. Now the next and very important last thing, that if you remember all these, we have these structures. So just tell me, do you understand all these things which I have told you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and what I will do, I will make a PDF of all these and I will share it with you. Okay, now this structure is given, see, and they have given the options here. This is the same, this structure is known as a 2-pinene. Okay, so 2-pinene, and here options are like 6, 7, 9, and 10, so four options are there. What I will do, I will make a, this structure is complicated, I will write down this structure in this fashion. For writing this, what I have did, I have hold this and I just take it outside the ring. So what I can see, that these two carbons are joined by using this carbon right here. See, this carbon is now outside the carbon, and remaining structure is as it is. Now what we will do, see, don't remember about A and B, just see where are the carbons are possible, or where hydrogens are there. Here there are CH3, is there any hydrogen here? No, because there are valence is complete. Here valence is 3, that means there will be one hydrogen. Here hydrogen is there. Here there is no hydrogen. Here there is hydrogen. Here there is hydrogen. Here there is hydrogen. And there is no symmetry at all. There is no symmetry axis. You cannot do any type of symmetry, or you cannot pass any axis through any which will give you the symmetry. So that's why the structure is unsymmetrical structure. And now we will find the hydrogen. For that purpose, see, these CH3, I will label them as an A. Why both are labeled as an A? Because they are present on the same carbon. Okay, so they will be like one. Here there is nothing, so I'll go from this side now, B. So here there is one hydrogen, so it will be B. Here there is a C, here there is a D. Okay, here there is nothing, so E, again I will come back, F and G. Total 7 types of peaks I can see. If you calculate this, there will be like an 8, and these are 2, so that's why I will come 1. So total 7 peaks will be there. Now what will you will have a doubt, like, sir, why these B and D are different, right? though this is looking as an symmetrical structure, but D is having a on adjacent carbon one methyl, but on the B's adjacent carbon there is nothing. So that's why these two are different now. Okay, so this particular question, I think this is asked in July 2019's question paper. I think this question is there. So this is for 2 marks. Okay, so is this clear or should I repeat this?
Clear, sir. Samajh le.
Okay, yes. So now next problem is the number of signal observed in this particular structure. Again, this is very complicated. What we will do, we'll go for first this particular structure and then we'll come again for this. So para toluidine, it's not para toluidine. So toluidine, generally they are asking para toluidine. First of all, you should know the structure of this compound. So what I did, I have drawn the structure for this particular compound here. See, the structure is like this. Okay, so this is the structure. If the aldehyde and methyl group, they are present at the para position of benzene, then we call this as a para toluidine. Okay, this is the structure. And para toluidine means here, if it is NH2 is present instead of aldehyde, that time this structure is been asked. Okay, so here see, can anybody tell me, can you tell me how many different types of protons are here? And I will also give you the options 1, 2, 3, 4, all the 4 options are there. So tell me.
Four,
sir.
How you have calculated? See, it's very simple. CH3, is there any CH3? No. So there is a 1. So what I will do, I will label here as an A. Now these two and these two hydrogens are there. These two are having aldehyde here. These two are having methyl. So I will label them, these two are as an B. These two are as an B. Why? Because they are the same. They are both are having the methyl here. And about this, there will be like C, we will see. And lastly, where is the D? The proton which is seen here. This is an aldehydic proton and we will give it an D. So total 4. So I can say 4. So I will see here. Is there an option 4? Yes. 3, 4, 5, 6. So 4 is the correct answer over here. Okay. Now the next is this particular structure. Though this structure look like a very complicated, but it's not complicated at all. Why? Because I can draw this structure in this fashion. Okay, so see both the structures are with you. Again, if I calculate the number of carbons here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 6 carbons are there, and those 1 and 4 number carbon is attached with the CH2. So only CH2 is there, and there is a 1 double bond. So what I will do, I have written here a 6 carbons cyclohexane, and I have joined this by using this CH2. There is 1 double bond and 2 hydrogens are there. Now, can you answer this question? There are hydrogens here. So both will be like 1. This structure is having a symmetry over here, right? Symmetry. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there any different answer than this? 4. Let's see the options. So we are going to see only H1 NMR. So only consider A. So we may have A as in 4, 8, 5, and 8 in the H1, not carbon, H1. 4 or 5 or 8. So 8 is obviously the answer. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are equivalent. So I can count them as an A for this, A for this. Then this is like B. This is B. Here there is a C. Okay. Now this one is D and this one is also D. So if you are not count this as an like a coupling constants. If you are not considering any coupling constant, we will get a different four types of protons. So I can say four different types of proton which will give four peaks. Okay, so here the option number A, it might be our answer. Okay, so this is the case for non-equivalent, or they are, means here hydrogen is there, here there is a hydrogen. So if they are present on the double bond, there is a cis and trans, such type of coupling is there, but we are not considering, we are just going for this particular structure. Okay, so here the answer will be like a 4. So this is about the number of different types of proton, and such type of questions are asked. There is one more question is there that match the following. So paraxylene, we already found the for paraxylene. What is paraxylene? Benzene ring, if it is having two CH3s. So I'll just make this as a paraxylene. If I remove this OH, this hydrogen and all this hydrogen. So this is a paraxylene structure. So it will give how many signals? See, one AA and all these are like B. So there will be two signals. So is there any? Yes, two signals in H1 NMR. That means this will be for paraxylene. So now what I have to choose, or how I have to choose? See, for I know for first it is C. So for first I will found out here that B and D is having a C option. Okay, so that means A and C is not correct. Only B or D is correct. Again, there is another one option is given. So what I will do? So I will found out this is by using IR. This is with the H1 NMR. This is with the UV. So we cannot find by using different things or different UV and C13 right now. But just for finding paraxylene, we will have this type of structure. One signal in H1 NMR. So it is not possible for this or for this particular structure. Okay, there is one more structure is given, 2,2 dimethyl propane. So I don't think for 2,2 dimethyl propane. So just what we will do, we will try to draw the structure. So how to draw the structure? Just take this bond. Okay, so one bond is there, another bond is there, and 2,2, what is the structure? 2,2 dimethyl propane. So 2,2. So 1,2, so 2,2 dimethyl and propane. So there will be one hydrogen, it will give two signals. So it is, I don't think it is given. Two signal in H1 NMR for B, for 4C. 4C. Okay, so for 4C, there is a difference. So this will be like A is the correct answer. Or we'll see this while we are solving the C13, okay? So that will be clear over here. So don't worry about this question. So all these questions have been asked in the SAT exam, and their codes are written. I have just taken a screenshot. You can see here, the screenshots are available. So in any SAT question paper, this particular for finding the number of protons is for, or they are asking this particular structure, or these problems for 4 marks. Okay, so this is very, very important. If you know that different types of protons, they are giving us a different type of signal, we will easily find out the different types of proton in given structure. Okay, so